Coming up on How We Built It, we're joined again by GE Aviation, this time to look at the steps that they're taking to modernize their on-premises records management system as they move incrementally to Azure, to make it easier for their airline customers to respond to new requirements and regulations. Now we'll look at their implementation of Azure's Custom Vision to improve the variety and also the accuracy of document searches. So I have on the show today Nate Hicks, who's a Senior Product Manager for GE Aviation's Digital Group. Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics.
Hi, and thanks for having me. It's great to be with you.
And thanks so much for joining us from Ohio today. So especially in these times, as flights are getting back up and running and airlines are under increased pressure to show that they can safely host passengers, whether that's checking the air filtration system on planes due to public health requirements with COVID-19, or also meeting industry standard general maintenance requirements, really being able to keep good records is more important than ever.
It sure is. And it can be a huge task across an airline's entire fleet to record and then easily retrieve evidence of maintenance activity or compliance to an airworthiness directive. A lot of what gets archived, things like parts receipts, vendor airworthiness certificates, or maintenance records are still paper-based. And these documents can contain both handwriting as well as printed text. And over the lifetime of an aircraft, we're literally talking about pallets of paper. So being able to convert documents that are in paper format to digital format, as well as process and store any documents that were never printed in the first place with scale, speed, and accuracy is more important than ever.
So how does the solution now work today?
Right. So today, most of our customers use our AirVault legacy records management product, which GE acquired a few years ago. And the best way for you to get an understanding is for me to actually show you the user experience. So when users first log in, they will arrive at the landing page. Documents get uploaded in a variety of different ways, and they go through some processing steps, and then they arrive in a customer's audit queue. Then the documents get audited in an application called Web Index. From here, I can select a batch of scanned documents. And when it opens, you can see that our system has taken this document batch containing four unique documents, as indicated by the green bars at the top, totaling 68 pages. Customers can then manually populate the index fields on the left, or they can automate this index tagging through integration with their maintenance system. And then when they're done, they can publish this to the appropriate records repository. On top of this legacy records management product, we built an application called Asset Transfer System, which provides both a project management and a records interface. In a project module, users can see projects to which they're assigned as stakeholders. They can create projects using industry standard checklists for a wide variety of project types to include things like aircraft transitions, annual reviews, or even engine transitions, and much more. The project module is enabled with a workflow and a third-party audit tool, where you can invite different parties from different organizations to collaborate on meeting specific document requirements. And this really enables remote collaboration and review. For example, here we are rejecting a document and then creating a workflow issue. Users can see and then interact with the aggregated list of open issues for a project, and they can get an at-a-glance view of project completion status. In the records module, users can search, view, and transfer records at an asset level using industry standard SPEC 2500 data formats. So to summarize, our product portfolio offers a wide range of product capabilities that encompass everything from digitizing paper records to searching, collecting, and then transferring those records to third-party agencies.
Okay, so given that a lot of your infrastructure currently is on-premises, how are you looking then to transform what you have in place today?
Right. So as you saw, we have our legacy application, and then we have modernized certain components of it with things like Asset Transfer System. Our ultimate goal is to rewrite everything using Azure Kubernetes services so that we can have key microservices that are easier to maintain and update the code base.
What incremental steps then have you taken to leverage Azure in a hybrid state then in the meantime?
Well, until now, we focused most of our efforts on enhancing the operational core, which is being able to automate the digitizing of records where we index them and then we make them searchable. At the end of the day, this is a production system that needs to be able to process about 200,000 files per day during peak times, and we can't afford downtime. So we've been really thoughtful about how we shift core services to the cloud in a way that does not impact our legacy application functionality. To start with, we figured out a way to take advantage of Azure Optical Character Recognition, or OCR, which is part of the Azure Custom Vision, by introducing a hybrid integration layer that creates a bridge between our legacy open source OCR system, our database hosted in our private data center, and Azure OCR. So this way, we can improve things like our OCR capability and expand on what we had with the legacy solution by adding new capabilities like handwriting recognition.
So how does this then all work?
Sure. So the first step is the document scanning. These scanned files get uploaded as image files. And if they're PDFs, we convert the pages to either a PNG image or a TIFF file, depending on whether they're color or black and white. These then go through a pre-processing pipeline that is configured for each customer. The whole goal of all these steps is to make these documents ready for OCR and then match up index values and metadata with images to make them searchable. For example, we auto-rotate the images if they're upside down. We also have a barcode reader that will read all the barcodes on the page and use that for index values. And another tool that identifies whether or not the image is a form. So indexing is then applied, and from there, they enter a queue passed to Azure via an API. This API connects to Azure Cognitive Services for the full text extraction. At this point, the index values and metadata are attached to the image and passed back to our legacy AirVault system via our integration translation layer and stored on a SAN. And the extracted text and metadata goes to a SQL database. Once that is done, the documents are fully discoverable and optimized for search in ATS or AirVault. In this way, we are able to leverage Azure OCR capabilities without requiring a system rewrite. And in the future, of course, our plan is to natively upload directly to Azure.
Okay, so how long did it take you then to get everything up and running and integrated with Azure?
Right, so once we had the integration layer built, it really took a couple of days to get the Azure OCR service itself configured and running.
What kind of performance are you seeing versus what you had before?
Yeah, it's really impressive. So we're talking about 35% faster processing speeds and about 60% more accuracy in terms of the data that it can extract. And just to show you how much more accurate, I'd like to show you a comparison of pre and post Azure OCR. Let me show you a comparison here for the same sample test that we had with the same 10-page document. We're here in SQL Server Management Studio. On the left is the output from our legacy OCR system, and on the right is the output of Azure OCR. Each row here represents a full page of a text extraction. And you'll notice a few things right away. On the right, you'll see that Azure OCR has uniformly captured the tabular data, whereas this is more inconsistent on the left. If we look into the document details, we can see the impact of those inconsistencies. So this is an example of an engine accessory report. It's basically an on-off log for parts coming into the shop versus parts going out. And it's a pretty standard format for maintenance, repair, and overhaul facilities. Pay attention to the nomination column as we compare results. Our legacy OCR engine has had some problems historically with accurately capturing highly tabularized data, especially with small printed text within small fields on the table. You'll see that in rows 230 to 280, it's not accurately capturing the part nomenclature. Also, the part numbers and serial numbers are not always clearly captured and searchable. And this is really important when searching for serialized parts. For example, if there's a part quality finding and you need to find out on which aircrafts it was installed. If you look at row 260, the serial number is EGS023. You'll see that the OCR read this as #68023. Now let's compare those results with Azure OCR that we've implemented. Here you can see the values that were missing in rows 230 to 280 are clearly represented and searchable, and the words are separated correctly. Also, our part numbers and serial numbers are correctly captured. If we look at the same row 260, the serial number EGS023 has been read accurately.
And that's quite a difference, but how do things work then with handwriting?
Yeah, so I mentioned earlier that our legacy solution really couldn't do handwriting with any sort of accuracy. So now I want to show you the improvement that we have with Azure OCR. I've opened our legacy AirVault web search application. This is where our customers come in to search their documents. Here they can search for a specific word contained in a document. In this case, I'll search for the word seat. This will take a minute, but to the human eye, in some cases, seat looks like scent, but the machine learning is able to derive context from the words around it. For example, co-pilot seat. And just to show that this isn't a fluke, I'm going to take a second word like insulation. You'll see it's returned highlighted results. Again, the penmanship here is pretty hard to decipher, but Azure OCR is able to find everywhere insulation shows up on this data set. What's interesting too is that beyond the handwriting, it also works really well in printed text. So if you zoom in on what's pretty distorted printed text and is 90 degrees out of rotation, it has still managed to pick up the word insulation. And what's even more impressive is that this is sandwiched between German language text. Now this is our test repository, but in our production environment, we have literally hundreds of millions of documents in our system. So this more advanced Azure OCR means that we have a richer auditability and searchability on our record sets.
So what else then do you have on your team then in plan for Azure?
Right. So we're currently also testing out Azure Forms Recognizer. Here in our process map, you can see some of the processing steps we use tailored to each customer. We work with the customer to identify specific document types. Our current process is that we leverage Forms OCR, which is a template-based solution. So we take a series of sample documents from the customer and we'll mark up the specific document attributes like task card that you can see here highlighted in yellow. This helps us to then identify the document type. And we then annotate the specific key value data pairs that we want to extract into index fields, as you can see here in the blue shaded zones. If you look at the word quarter, the extracted text does not match the handwritten value on the right, 17382. Similarly, if you see the task card number, the extracted text is missing a few characters. Using Azure technology, I can upload a form in the same way, but it goes through a simplified process map and has higher accuracy with extracting printed and handwritten text. So now if we look at the results again, the work order number was correctly transcribed and the task card number is completely captured. Additionally, the Azure Forms Recognizer solution enables a more efficient mechanism for training the document classification. And you can see here how the document type was correctly identified as a task card. And as we streamline the process for scanning and indexing our documents, we'll be able to use Azure Search across our entire body of both structured and unstructured data for more powerful search results and data utilization.
I know that GE Aviation's digital group is also experimenting with Azure Synapse Analytics for predictive maintenance. So how will this help in your scenario in this case?
Right. So ultimately, our goal is going to be to move our system and all of its data into Azure. And when we do that, Azure Synapse will help us to build analytical models that allow us to view the records data across our various products.
Thanks so much for joining us today, Nate. And also, if you're interested in learning more about GE's records management system, check out airvault.com. And to learn more about Azure OCR, Cognitive Services, Azure Search, and Azure Synapse Analytics, visit azure.com. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe to Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates across Microsoft. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.